So I really do think this will be the last time I speak on this topic and really put an end to the storybook that has been the Fresh and Fit saga. You better not say one bad word about these guys, cause they'll get really mad. As most of you probably know, close to a month ago, Fresh and Fit decided to try and copyright strike over 30 YouTube channels who had made critical videos about their brand. This included channels like Abba and Preach, Playback, Spencer Cornelia, and of course your boy the Tan Superman. I mean, they really tried to get me out of here, guys, with 3 separate copyright strikes. In a nutshell, they were tired of people talking about them and their brand on the internet and basically sought to censor and silence any sort of criticisms involving their name and their business. This eventually got handled in a variety of ways. As this story gained more and more traction, more people saw them in the wrong, because this is a big no-no in the YouTube landscape to abuse the copyright system in this way, because all these videos they were striking fell under fair use. The thing is, when you choose to become a public figure, you have to be ready to face criticism, and when you are selling a product, I would say even more so. Them trying to get these videos taken down is like this guy calling himself a legit doctor and then trying to silence those who say otherwise. It's like a restaurant owner raging at someone who gives their food a 1-star Yelp review and trying to get it taken down. You know, in the past, I've actually given these guys a lot of credit because the show they produce is not an easy one to manage. My whole point in making those videos was that I felt their business model was just the blind leading the blind, and that people should not take their word as bond because they tended to have hypocritical tendencies, and that they love to throw rocks and then hide their hands. A classic case of the guru not practicing what they preach. It's really a story as old as time. And I bring them up again because recently they went on Tim Pool's podcast, and when a viewer asked a question about the recent copyright drama, they got absolutely schooled by this man, Tim Pool.
Adam Griffin says, can you ask why these clowns tried to take down ABBA and Preach with fake DMCA strikes?
What?
You want to go into it?
So basically,
we have a lot of people that talk about us on the internet, and some of it is slander, some of it is defamation, and using our content in their videos, and we're like, okay, cool. We've waited out for a while for you to stop. You're still doing it. So, oh, you know what? Cool. Obviously, you're attacking our character and our integrity. So at that point, hey, it's all fair game.
So basically, these self-opposed high-value men didn't like people calling out their hypocrisy. Also, abusing the copyright system is not the correct way to take legal action in this case. They keep throwing around words like slander or defamation, when in reality, most people speaking about them were merely recapping things that happened on their show and saying what they think about those things based on their personal experience. There was nothing inherently false about anything anyone said, and most of it was really just a matter of opinion, like calling them nerds and frauds based on something someone else said or discovered. I mean, if you went out there and said, oh, he beats men and he touches kids, yeah, of course, something like that is slander. Calling someone a simp and calling someone a nerd, on the other hand, that's just making a joke. Literally thousands of YouTube videos are uploaded like this every single day about all different topics and people. I'm telling you, when you are a public figure, people can pretty much say whatever they want about you. And if they have reservations about your public show or your public business, they can make those reservations known to others without being silenced. They wanted these channels not only censored, but deplatformed altogether because they are afraid of being exposed. Period. And you don't want to be insecure like this, fellas. That's why I'm so happy to announce that I'm once again teaming up with Teach Hanley for the sponsor of today's video. Like many men out there, before Teach Hanley, I would struggle to even wash my face every day or stick with any sort of skincare routine because I really did not know what I was doing at all. But with their level 1 skincare system, they make everything very simple for guys like you and I, and after a while, it'll really just be like second nature for you to take care of your face. The level 1 system comes with a face wash, a 2 times per week exfoliating scrub, as well as an AM and PM moisturizer so your face will be hydrated all day every day. It might sound crazy, but I really do look forward to starting and ending my day with Teach. My favorite part is that every box comes with an instruction card that tells you when to use each product, how much to use, and in what order. In addition to amazing skin, members of Teach Hanley get a ton of benefits, including 25% off the retail price, the ability to customize your box, as well as the ability to pause or cancel at any time. And you get free shipping within the US. And because Teach Hanley is sponsoring today's video, they're offering my viewers a great deal. Just click the first link in the description, and not only will you get Teach Hanley for the best possible price, but they'll also give you a free gift with your first box. So what are you waiting for? Click that link and get started for just $30.
If someone breaks into your store, right, and takes a broom off, you have a hardware store, takes a broom off the shelf and starts beating you with your own broom and won't leave and does it for 4 months, what are you going to do?
Well, you can't file a DMCA over it.
Apparently not. You can't.
Yeah.
Dude, no one is beating you up with your own broom. You just keep whacking yourself in the face with it over and over again, and people are pointing and laughing. It's like you're walking through a field of rakes and you keep stepping on every single one so it can rise up and smash you in the face. To keep painting it like there's some poor little victim is hilarious given their Alpha Lord brand. Tim didn't even know about this topic going in, but as the YouTube veteran he is, he understands the rules and is obviously gonna advocate for free speech and criticism of public figures.
When it comes to public figures and defamation cases, it's really hard to win.
It is.
If I downloaded your video and then I started just playing clips while commenting on it, it's fair use. It's very difficult to win that. But I've got people who go to timcast.com, take those behind a paywall, publish them on, you know, online, and then comment on them. Now that's the line. I don't go after him still, though.
So basically what Tim is saying is that they have no case. He says when people take him out of context, a straight up lie about something he said, he just ignores it because it just comes with the territory at this point. Over the years, a couple of people have made very critical videos about me. Some of them used large chunks of my content, and I couldn't give a single shit. Because guess what? It's still for under fair use, and I know some people are just gonna hate me along the way. When making content, you always have to remember the rule of 10. When you make something, 3 people will love it, 3 people will hate it, and 4 people will feel indifferent about it. The idea that you should silence all criticism against yourself is some Kim Jong-un shit. I mean, imagine if people were only allowed to say positive things about each other. The internet would be no fun. Also, for the record, I think people making these videos about them actually helped to propel them up the YouTube ladder much faster than they would have otherwise.
But a big thing on fair use where, you know, it hurts your ability to get protected by fair use is, are you hurting that other person's ability to profit from their own product?
If you're a photojournalist and you sell photos for a living, mm-hmm. and then you post a sample on Twitter and you say to license this photo, buy it here, and then people start posting it everywhere, now you've got copyright infringement, because even though it's online, even though it's newsworthy, and even though people are commenting on it, they're infringing on your market because you directly sell this content, which means you said license it from me. If you guys do a publicly available show and people post it and comment on it, you got no case. You can't DMCA it.
So basically, he slam dunked on everything they tried to do without even knowing they were trying to do this sleazy shit in the first place. At the end of the day, these are some sensitive alphas right here. You know, their whole business model is basically trying to slam dunk on loose Miami women, but don't let someone slam dunk on their head because they will be ready for war. Either way, guys, this was a fun way to end the year. Also, just wanted to hop on here real quick and say thank you, guys, and I love you very much for all the support you showed me. I mean, this year was absolutely insane. Y'all allowed me to buy my first house. Y'all allowed me to put myself in a very comfortable position, so I'm always going to be in debt to y'all. As always, I do want to thank you guys for watching, and one more time for subscribing for this year, 2021. It's been your boy, the Tan Superman, and I gotta go fly away. I'm out. Peace.